I wanted to talk to you guys this morning about how... Oh, yeah, come on here, Jensen. I need your wisdom here. I want to talk about houses, like the places that we live. So do you guys... Where do you guys live? Can you describe where you guys take your residence? Where you guys... Where's your tablets right now? At home. Okay, so what is your home? Do you... What kind of home do you guys have? A car, did you say? Oh, your tablet's in the car. Okay. Still stuck on the tablets. But where's your guys' bed? In a house. Yeah, in a house. So thinking about the different types of houses that people have or throughout the ages. I got some pictures of some houses, if you guys know what these are. I'll move over to the side here. Do you know, you guys know what that is?
Igloo.
Igloo, that's right. Do you guys know the name of the people that would that lived in igloos?
Penguins?
They can. Yeah, the Eskimos. Eskimos lived in there. And the next, yeah, what are those? Teepees, yeah. So those Indians use those. Those are tents, right? So across the whole world, the different types of people use tents, you know, for their living spaces. That tents were great because they offered protection from the elements, but then if you guys had to move and go to a different spot, it like if we picked up our house and moved, that wouldn't be very easy, right? No. So tents were great that you could pack up your house and move to the different spot. Okay, so in kind of light on there, so most people, they don't like tents. Now, for those that like their home but also would enjoy moving around, we have our next picture here. And what's that? An RV. Now, we got some of people in the congregation that have those things. So not many people are about the RV life, but the RV life chooses you, right? It doesn't, you don't choose the RV life. But these are kind of examples. Those are houses that are not permanent. They move around. You, even the Eskimos, they didn't live in those the igloos. They used it to protect themselves while they were hunting. So that wasn't the house that they stayed in. But you guys' homes, let's see here, like that. So y'all's homes is in a permanent place. And a fancy word for saying what you guys live in is that you dwell in that house. So that means that you guys have settled in. Just think of like your dad sitting in a recliner, okay? He settles into that recliner. He sits in there, okay? And so when you settle into your place, then you can invite people to your home. You can do a whole lot of things when it comes to that. And in the Bible, it talks about God's dwelling place. So the early Israelites, they built a tabernacle, and it said that when it was all completed, that God descended and he dwelled in that tabernacle. It's like a tent. And then later on, David and then later his son Solomon built a temple for God. And so also in the same, the temple, God descended in there and he dwelt in there. And that was a place that God and people could dwell, live together. Now, the awesome thing about what Jesus had done, in John, it talks about that the Word was made flesh, and it dwelt among us. So it's talking about Jesus, that he lived, that he settled himself around people like you and me. And now, the great thing about Jesus' death and resurrection is that Paul also said to the Corinthians that he is dwelling in our hearts, like that our bodies are temples, just like the temple was that God for the Israelites. Now our bodies are that house, that's that permanent residence that God, through his son Jesus, sets in our hearts. Now the thing is, it's God or Jesus, when he enters in our hearts, it's not like, oh, switching it back over, sorry, putting you guys on the fly here, like the RVs or the tents or the igloos. It's not a temporary residence. It's not something that Jesus sits in our hearts on Sundays, or when we're doing holidays like Easter and Christmas, does he want in our hearts the whole time? So that's a permanent residence, just like your house. But Jesus needs the whole house. He needs our whole heart in order for him to dwell in ourselves. So we have to remove all those things that we clutter up, that we can have Jesus come and fill that house, so that when he fills our temple, that we can do amazing things. But we can only do that is if we ask Jesus to come into our hearts. Okay? We got to give him everything. We can't hold anything back. We can't have it be a temporary home or an in-law's house that's just close by. It has to be a permanent house in our hearts. Does that sound pretty easy to do? No, it's not very easy to do. So let's ask God through Jesus to help us have our hearts be a permanent home for Jesus, okay? Let's pray. Dear God, we thank you, Lord, that you sent your Son to dwell among us, that his death and resurrection has now meant that our bodies, our hearts can be temples that you can dwell in and transform our lives. We know that your house is required that you take up permanent residence and that you take every square inch of that place. And we ask, Lord, that you help us to clear out all the clutter that's inside our hearts, the things that hinder us from letting you in, Lord. And we know that we cannot do that on our own. And we ask for the Spirit to find all those dirty places and that we can clean those out so that Jesus can enter in and transform our lives. We pray this, Lord, in your Son's precious name. And all God's kids say, amen. Amen. Ooh.